So it's the end of March and it's time for daylight saving time to begin. So I've got a lot of work ahead of me. As you can see, all my clocks must now be set forward an hour. This clock should be wired up to control other clocks. It is in fact a master clock. However, some of the master clock bits aren't in it. So for the time being, this is functioning as a standalone wall clock. This is a little bit unfortunate. Hopefully all that will change someday in the not too distant future. This one may take a little while to adjust. This one, on the other hand, should be fairly straightforward. As should this one. Oops. Now this one has to be moved out of the way so I can get to this one, which is behind a glass door. The easiest way to adjust this one is just move the hour hand, as it is quite slack. Now with this one you need to use the key to adjust it. Ingenious dust cover. With this one, the entire top has to come off. Sorry if you can't see this one, it's in a very dark corner. Thank you. I forgot to wind this one up last week because it's in a dark corner and I can't see it. But then I should have remembered it was there. But I'm a little bit lacking in brain sometimes. And the one you've all been waiting for. And this one I only got put together yesterday, although I've had it for over 8 years. And my first successful grasshopper escapement construction. And now, out of the living room, into the hallway. Oops, a minute fast. Right, that's fine. Now we're halfway up the stairs. The easiest way to set this clock to the time is to move the other hand. And then, because it's a striking clock, too near the hour to reset the striking. I'll have to come back to that one in 5 minutes' time. This one might be tricky. Hold the clock in one hand and the camera in the other. No, can't be done. I'll have to take the clock down off the wall. Okay, it's now done. I had to do it off camera because it is completely impossible to set this the time with one hand and hold the camera in the other. Just as a matter of interest, this clock has a towel stuffed behind it. The reason why is because, being a mains clock with a metal case, when the metal case is hanging directly against the wall, it hums, and it's quite distracting when I'm trying to go to sleep, and the towel completely muffles it, so it doesn't hum. And my two trusty bedside companions. This one had to be completely rebuilt this year. Come on. You haven't seen this one before, but this was in fact the first clock I ever saw as a child. This was in our first house. Okay, it's a little bit tricky to start sometimes. Aha, that's it going. The Genelex Delhi Minor. It was the first clock I saw when I was a small child. And it's been in our house ever since. I almost never use lights inside this clock nowadays. It's now late spring, and I don't need a clock to light up my darkened bedroom. This is another one I might have difficulty adjusting on camera. It's an East German Glashütte Elektrochron. A high quality electromechanical movement. And it is now at new time. Now to catch up with this one and reset the striking. That is the decimal clock. I'm going to have to wait till 12 noon to start that one going. I've set it to 500, which is 12 noon in decimal time. It's absolutely impossible to set it to the time at any other time than 12 noon or midnight. So I've set it to 500, and when it comes to 12 noon, I'll plug it in. Well, if you liked this video, then please click like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.